truly I tell you, Pharisees, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in some other way, is a thief and a robber. The one who enters the gate by the gate is a shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He will call his own sheep by their name and leads them out. When he has brought all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will never run away. They will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice. Jesus uses this figure of speech, but the Pharisees do not understand what he was telling them. Therefore, Jesus said again, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who have come before me are thieves and robbers. But the sheep have not listened to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it full. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me. Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. The reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life, only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay down in front of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This is the command I received from my Father." The Jews who heard these words again were divided. Many of them said, "He is demon-possessed and raving mad. Why listen to him?" But others said, "These are not sayings of a man possessed by a demon. Can a demon open the minds of the blind?" This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.